supposed to, and state out false facts and things like that about
defamation.
Exactly, just because you're popular. And you know, the whole Ian Mogoya saga came out
with
the other time. It was, he was actually exposed on this page, and they said how he was sharing an inbox with this girl and asking different mamas for like money, because he doesn't have any money.
Oh my goodness. You know, I went to high school with Ian. I went to high school with Ian, and he's been a very close friend for some time. I'm not in support of Ian, but I mean,
but the guy should be making money. The guy's on Straight Up like every day.
Man, but no, Straight Up is not Hollywood, man. So
true.
Straight Up is not Hollywood. So
do you think it's true?
Because that Ian is a gold digger? If Ian was listening,
relationship.
Yeah.
You know, I wouldn't state facts, or you know.
But you know, there
were a lot of rumors that the girlfriend used to give him the Q7 Audi,
the
which
BMW.
You drive around, you know, drive around in, swerve around the hood in,
boy,
courtesy of Kiricho.
Industry.
An industry that you guys are very familiar with, I'm sure.
Yeah, the Vienna.
And you know, he went up on Straight Up the next day, and I think he addressed it. And admin lashed out at him and said, you know, calling him names. So what I don't understand is why admin has to stand behind this curtain. Exactly. If you want to come out and attack people and you say you have your facts, come out and do
like
it to
Miguna.
My face.
Like Miguna did.
Yeah.
He came out factual, like, and he wasn't afraid of anything.
Yeah.
So that the admin is a coward.
It's
a coward.
And on top of that, you know, guys that take pictures from other places and then put them there and say you did this or you were here doing that.
Yeah.
That's not cool. Do we even have laws in Kenya? Imagine going to a law.
There are laws against defamation, but
It's defamation. That's exactly what it is. But the same thing happened to me last year.
Oh my goodness.
I went to Mr. and Miss USA. You're looking quite lovely, if I must say. And I had on this dress, okay, not that much, but you know, you're getting the gist.
You are.
I was standing there, a guy was like, yeah, let me take a picture for you, and I was like, yo, I know I'm tipsy, but are you working with USIU? Yeah, I'm for USIU, I'm for USIU Press, whatever.
Yeah.
It's there, me and my girls were smiling there. Hey.
Posing.
Next thing, we end up on a hate page on Facebook, and this stylista chick that blogs or whatever is going, the worst is the chick in the middle. Guess who the chick in the middle was?
Oh my goodness.
She looks
like, in the room?
You look like this, you're pathetic, Now I was trying to track down this chick to be like, yo, what's your beef? Okay, beef on my clothes, not me. You know? But they always standing behind this what? This
curtains.
I don't know what that's about, but we'll investigate more.
You know but that's the price of fame. You know, you have to pay it. And then they're on a money making spree.
These guys,
So as long as guys hear news about Waihiga, they'll be right there clicking.
Yeah.
The website will have hits.
True or false.
And then the advertisers. So it's one big cartel of.
But you know, guys should realize, you know, things you post about other people, malicious lies, truthful facts, whatever, you know, you can really ruin someone's career,
you know,
someone's reputation.
Paparazzi is big business in Hollywood.
Exactly. And the worst, the most actually famous is the Kate Middleton's topless pictures.
Man.
You know that guy?
Royalty. Insults to royalty.
I think he was about to be arrested. They filed charges against him.
Oh.
And another guy actually.
Or the publisher of the photos.
The one who released the photos. The one
because
who
the photographer, the paparazzi, sold the pictures.
Yeah, but you know, that's an invasion of privacy.
That's
they were out in the sea. It's not like she went to an event topless and was like, know.
Yeah, I am.
No,
she
but
was
then,
in a private place. You
but
know,
the debate
having.
Is, she's a public figure. She's a public figure and people want to know.
You know, like there's a line that says, behind every successful man, kuna mwingine anajaribu kumpickpocket. You know, all these paparazzis are trying to make
money
off you.
Yeah, but then don't be stupid. It's like going after like Obama, taking like nude pictures of him and thinking that the CIA ain't gonna come for you.
At the IP address.
You cannot.
Did you see the look in her eye?
Yeah? She was like,
Obama.
I'm a secret agent here.
No, but you know, you can't do such things and not think that there will be consequences. Yeah, you can go bug on Lindsay Lohan. I mean, she has money, but she doesn't have
like the
power or influence like to that stature in
detectives,
government. Exactly. So, you know, just be careful. I mean, I want to talk about this story.
But as long as the Kenyan industry, is mediocre,
yeah,
you know, in its professionalism and all,
yeah,
you know, certain things are bound to happen.
It's true. It's true.
Because
you said it right. There's a very mediocre about
approach.
Being professional to any part
anything.
Of this industry.
Yeah.
Any. If you want to go to film and start on a series, you're starting 10 hours later, Cedric. You know, that
auditions are just bugged, whatever.
Exactly. So I think, you know, we have to make a change from within, yo.
But you as someone who's slightly, you know, a public figure, what would you say, like, what would be the right thing for them to do?
Admin, step out of those curtains, man, and talk. Address people.
Talk clever. Yeah.
Address people, because if you said something,
yeah,
if they said something about you,
yeah,
who do you go after and you want to sue them? You want to sue the page?
Let me tell you.
You need your facts.
If I found myself in one of
the
pages,
the IP address, you track it down.
You know what I'd do? I'd find you, deal with you.
You, there and then, man to man.
Because honestly, how can you go and talk about bad about me?
Yeah.
And I haven't done anything wrong in the public.
But isn't that contradicting? What you guys said? Because I asked you guys at the beginning of this conversation. You guys read those stories and you're like, yeah, we enjoy them. So it's basically about, if it's not me.
Oh, no. It's not like that. You know, being someone.
Wait, Waiga, do you read those stories?
Do you enjoy them?
I mean, they pass my newsfeed. So, technically, they are on my newsfeed.
They are not.
I don't click and go see more.
You subscribe to that page.
They're
on the walls.
Yeah.
And you look and you're like.
And you read them,
Then you move on. Not like at you, whatever.
But Waihiga, what I get is that you're not against the stories.
Yeah.
You're against, like, the nature in which they come out.
Exactly.
And who brings them out?
Exactly.
Who publishes them?
Exactly. If you're gonna say something
and it's factual,
come out and say it. Don't hide behind the curtain and start, you know, provoking people like, yeah, I got you. Yeah, I'm stalking you. Ah, I know who you are. Ah, I'm gonna find you. Ah, you know, that's what they were saying on this page.
Oh,
so you know what? We'll talk about this more. The time is 1:50. Let's go back to the tracks. DJ, no ID. Twenty cards. You